Okay, so hello everyone again. Today we're gonna do a choux pastry. So very classic. It's a very old recipe. It's been created in 1540 in the 16th century by someone, I can't remember his name, Pantaleni. So probably Italian. And then the recipe been passed on to the French and did more things, obviously, with it. So we're gonna need, I'm gonna do a big recipe because I'm gonna use it for our shop on same time. So you will have just to divide it. So I start with 2 liters of water. And in there I'm gonna put 30 grams of salt. Oh, that's too much. Yeah, 30. The salt help for the color. And the butter, 800 grams. Let's cut it in small pieces. And we drop everything in a pan. And we're gonna boil this water. There we go. So once it's boiling, we're gonna need 1 kilo 600 of flour. Done. And crack 40 eggs. So I'm gonna weight it up the eggs because they're never regular, especially we are using free range ones, so they're all different. Straight from the farm. So 1 egg, this should be 50 grams, and I need 40 of them. So that's gonna make 2 kilo of eggs. So that's the wrong box. It's pretty soft. The water is boiling, the butter's melted, salt is boiling, so that's good. So we're gonna add the flour out of the stove, otherwise it's gonna burn the bottom. So in French we're calling la panade. I don't know in English really how you will call this mix. So once your flour it's all incorporated, you're gonna have to pull it back on your stove and you're gonna have to dry your panade, your mix. So that means you're removing the most humidity you can from this dough, because when you're gonna add the eggs into it, why the choux pastry is rising is because of the fat containing into this pastry and the eggs. So the humidity of the eggs want to get out, but there is these shelves of butter who block it, so it just explodes. It's a kind of a puff pastry principle. So if it's not dry enough, it's not gonna rise much. And when you stir it and it falls apart, that means it's ready. It falls apart in pieces, as you can see. You see? It falls apart. So that means it's dry. It's very oily, but dry. Okay, so that's dry into your bowl. And we're gonna add the eggs one by one or two by two. Using a paddle. Slow speed. But I'll put 5 eggs to start. And then 2 by 2 and wait till it's incorporate and a bit more. So let's check, I've put all my 40 eggs. Maybe we're gonna scrape all around just to make sure everywhere is mixed. That's look quite good consistency. So it's got to be shiny and running. So let's mix a little bit more. That's ready. Sometimes you need to add a few more eggs, or when you coming to the end of your 40 eggs, just check before your mix before to add the last ones, because sometimes it needs less, sometimes it needs more. It depends on how you dry your panade at the beginning in your pan. So see, this one is running, but stay in form and it's shiny. So that means it's ready. Okay, so let's pipe it now. It's very sticky. Let's start with big ones. So here we are using just oily tray, not too much oil, otherwise it's not gonna be very easy to pipe, because it's gonna be slippy. So just enough, really. And then with choux pastry, you can do anything, like choux, éclairs, Paris breast, lots. Right, éclairs. So that's the éclairs. You got to think how much they're gonna rise in your oven. They go double, even triple size. So it's quite difficult to guess, really. Then if you want they rise regularly, you're gonna have to egg wash them. Mapul, do you have a fork?
Yes.
Top. If you want them to rise regularly, so you egg wash them, but it's gonna make a beautiful chai. Then with your fork, you just trace a line like this. And for sure they're gonna rise perfectly equal. But I don't do that because I like rustic look. I like when it grows like a bit like crazy. So that's eclairs. Choux the same. Need to think about how they're gonna rise. So when you do a choux, it's nice to have a beautiful bowl when it's cooked. So if you go lada and after lada and lada, it's gonna go like everywhere when it's gonna cook. So it's not very nice. You really need to smooth it to make sure it's gonna be okay. Oh, again, egg wash. And with your fork. Voilà. Okay, so now it's all piped, we're gonna stick it in the oven. So this is our bread oven, if you want to do it at home. This is 190 degrees. And we keep it closed, and because we got a kind of cheminée, an extraction, when the choux pastry start to rise, full rise, but still white and very fragile, if you open the door, it's gonna collapse. Because you need to keep the whole humidity you can in your oven. If you open the door, that's it. So when it's come to this stage, when it's rise and nearly colored, when it's gonna get color, you open your cheminée, remove all the moist, all the humidity out of your oven slowly. So at home, you can do it on slightly open your oven door and stick a spoon or a cloth or anything like that just to release all the humidity from your oven and let it dry your choux pastry and finish to color it. It's very complicated, but if you open your door, it collapses. Okay, so I did open my cheminée to remove all the steam. They did start to color. Now it's very safe to open your door because they got colors, so they will keep their shape. So it's very white. So you just finish it to cook it like that until you get a satisfied color you would like. That's all.